A Tube Audiobooks Creations, not-for-profit producers of audiobooks for blind and print disabled.
To support, subscribe, like, share our channel www.youtube.com/tubeaudiobooks. Visit our website for more information www.tubeaudiobooks.com. Follow our page at facebook.com/tubeaudiobooks. One of the best ways of improving your English is to read the language. This part of our audiobooks includes complete content by some of the very best writers. All contents are complete and unabridged. Listen to them online or listen to them in bed. We hold commercial license for all the voices of narrators.
Saint Gopala Swamigal of Sinchuvadi village in the Udamalpet, Tamil Nadu, it is said that do not go in search of the roots of any saints as you will never find it. It is absolutely true in the case of Saint Gopala Swamigal also. Nobody clearly knows from where he came, why he came and so on, but he was there in the Sinchuvadi village. His abode was a small Perumal, Vishnu temple in the village. He was very reluctant to meet people. He never accepted money from anybody else for whatsoever reason it may be. Very simple, he was half naked with a green turban and a green dhoti always. Sinchuvadi village is a very small village, very far away from the usual pollution and noise of any city. Very silent, with full of greenery everywhere. Perhaps that may be the reason Swamigal has selected this place as his abode to grace his devotees. As said, he was not interested in meeting people. He used to shout at people, "Why? Why you are coming here and disturbing me? Don't you have any other business?" But his devotees know that this anger is only at the outset and not from his heart, as he was so lovable and caring for his devotees. His devotees need not tell their names to him. If they are lucky, he will call them by their names as if he already knows them. Many of the villagers says that Swamigal has shown his Vishwa Rupa, Mahima, to many, to say about 8 main powers acquired by a spiritual person as listed in the Indian scriptures are Anima, Mahima, Garima, Lahima, Prapti, Prakamya, Isatva, Vasatva. There are other lists of such powers too, however these are the most discussed yogic powers. Ashta Siddhasa, Anima, ability to reduce the size of the body, sometimes even to the size of the atoms. Becoming smaller than the smallest, as described in Srimad Bhagavatam by Lord Krishna. For example, Hanuman had reduced the size of his body while he was searching for Sita in Lanka. Mahima, ability to assume a gigantic form, becoming larger than the largest, as described in Srimad Bhagavatam by Lord Krishna. For example, Hanuman assumed a huge form to burn Lanka. He also assumed big form to fight Kumbhakarna. In Vamana avatar, Lord Vishnu increased his form, which was so gigantic that it only took him 3 steps to cover all 3 worlds. Garima, ability to become very heavy in weight by will. For example, Lord Hanuman made his tail very heavy that even Bhima couldn't lift it. Bhima, who was climbing the Gandhamadana mountains to get Saugandhika flowers for Draupadi, was stopped by a monkey whose tail was on the way. Bhima orders the monkey to take the tail off the road. Monkey, being old, tells him to move it himself, but Bhima couldn't even lift the monkey's tail. Lahima. Lahima comes from the word lahu, which means small or light. Lahima is the ability to make the body very light, becoming lighter than the lightest. Levitation and flying in the air are its subsidiary powers. Prapti. Word prapti means to obtain, having obtained, to have got. Thus prapti is the ability to acquire anything anywhere. Prakamya. The ability to obtain anything desired, ability to have realized the dreams. Isatva. Isa equals Lord, Isatva equals Lordship, the power of absolute lordship over entire creation. Vasatva. The ability to have everything under control, especially the physical manifestation made up of 5 elements. Saint Gopala Swamigal might have been in possession of all these powers. He used to have communicate with the Supreme like we talk in mobile phone. He used to place one of his hands in the ear and partially close it and say, "Oh, is it like that?" It is very difficult to understand him. He was very different than other saints. He hated crowd and preferred to be alone always. Once a person who later became a researcher, who used to meet him regularly, the saint used to tell him without looking at him, excavating all the time. The person did not know why Swamigal said like this until he became a popular researcher and started mining knowledge. Once Swamigal said to the same person, "The train goes on, no driver but Gurad." Here the word God can be taken as God, as this person was at a later stage was seriously ill and was admitted into the hospital and was decaled dead by the doctors, but after 15 minutes he sprang back to life. Perhaps what Swamigal meant to say was, you need not be afraid of death, your life will go on like a train and the guard, fate cannot stop it, only God decides it. Swamigal was looked after by a lady who was addressed by his devotees, Amma. She speaks very fluent English and her knowledge in spirituality was incomparable. Perhaps her acquaintance with Swamigal had blessed her with this. Although Swamigal did not like crowd, people from different parts of the country came to meet him and get his blessings. India is blessed with not one but many divine personalities like Saint Gopala Swamigal. That is why India stands number one in many fields in the world.